is.
Well, there it is. Hey, this is Witty, and this is, of course, a 4 versus 4 RT random team. Is it the map deadlock? I think it might be. I think it just might be. So let's have a little look at this strategy. This is by Paz Earl.
Hi, you want strong strategy? Maybe I have one. Go for human of-
I don't know why I always seem to end up doing an American Texas accent. No matter what voice I'm doing, even if it's high pitch, but hey ho.
Go for human and focus these heroes and skills. First hero, Mountain King. Stormboat, Stormboat, Stormboat. Second hero, Panner. Breath of Fire. Third hero, Naga Sea Bitch. Fork Lightning. And units are up to you. Have fun.
Okay. Well, that was kind of embarrassing. I didn't want it to turn out like that at all. But since I started the voice that way, I kind of felt like I needed to continue it. Fast expansion, definitely. And then straight into Tekken. And that'll allow me the heroes, because we're going to go try heroes this game. Get some trifecta in there. And then units, I can pretty much do what I want. But Footman would be reliable. It might be interesting to get some mercs as well. I might try that. Maybe I'll do that, actually. Maybe I just won't even build Footman at all. It's risky, because in order to get the mercs, I'm going to take a bit of damage. But I could always creep this out with Militia. Potentially. It's a little bit overkill in terms of the wood that I'll be losing from chopping away on it with my peasants, but I'm still willing to give that a go. Mountain King first as well. He's not a great creeping hero for a first hero. But that's the way I think I'm going to play this. Because I like to play it more risky, more over the top. For bigger reward, basically. So that's what I'm going for. So we'll get some mercs in there. Probably should just get a lumber mill, because that's going to be useful no matter what. And then with these, I might try to nick... Just send one militia over there. That way I can potentially just pick up a merc. And it might take some damage, but I should be able to get it out of there more or less intact. And I'm in the middle here, so I shouldn't be too likely to get killed. And I have my choice of expansions, should I choose to take one, which I almost definitely shall. Oh my goodness, I thought that was like a full-on rush there. I was like, oh no, it's not going to be ghouls and everything. At least he knows how to react. That's very handy. So let's try to do this merc camp first. Not got that many peasants, though. I'm going to walk over there. Because he's going to need help. I'm tempted to wait until... No, I can't really. I'll get over there, do what I can. But at night time, at certain points in the game, you can buy boots of speed and staff of teleportation, which would be very handy for dealing with this. He's doing a good job dealing with this. Let's give him a little bit of gold to handle himself. Oh, wow, they're all going at it. So I'm almost there. Unfortunately, I don't have the units ready to back him up, but I can potentially get mercs. Let's get on that Archmage. I can get Scroll of Speed as well from his shop and Clarity Pot. They're going to go on me now. But that's okay, that's kind of distracting them at the very least, so I'll just back off and then go back onto the Archmage. Boom, big mistake. Merc, I can get a Centaur Outrunner. Should I go for it? Probably should. I could actually possibly kill that Archmage. Because I can keep up with him now. Oh, he TP'd out. I wouldn't be able to insta-kill him. Let's try this. Let's get a Centaur Merc. Don't particularly want to have to do this, but at least it allows me to get units. I'm just going to tech now because this distraction is hurting us a bit. Ooh, he's taking a little bit there. Now my allies are there. I'm going to take another Clarity Pot. Keep on him. Keep the CC. Try to get in front. Block him off. And there we go. That's not bad. Alright, let's try to do the... thinking about it. I've got to just regroup everything together. I'm going to do this shop bit here. Take the item. Then I'm going to staff a teleport back and take an expansion, because both are free. Probably the one above me is going to be the one of choice. So here you go, staff a teleportation, boost of speed, very useful items. Let's get some peasants ready. They're going on him already again. It's a bit annoying. But I suppose it makes sense. So you're going to teleport back to base. These guys can finish this off and then come meet up with you. Maximum efficiency. Tech is still going. Gotta give me a moment, mate. I can't, unfortunately. Okay, the damage is being spread quite nicely here, for the most part. One of my guys did die there. Apparently I didn't pay attention to his health bar, but I seem to see everything else. Okay, so Tech's going through. Oh, they found that, have they? I'm going to get ready to buy another hero from that. I can staff a teleport. No, I can't. I'll just walk up there. I've got the boost of speed, so that's something at least. Okay, it's going through, so let me just check what the other bit is I'm supposed to get here. Have they disappeared? Ah. Alright, well, let's look for other stuff to creep whilst I have another check again. Ah, oh, Panda's next, and then Naga Sea Bitch, okay. Won't be too long. This guy really doesn't like me. He's going to sit there the whole time. It's going to get him killed if he spends any longer there. Wait. It's night time, so you can't see. Oh, where are you going? Where are you going? Why did you just decide to suddenly disappear? That's a bit odd. And yeah, these guys are clearly map hackers, because they're just all over the place. You know what I mean? They're two on the ball. I figured as much. It's that sort of suspicion. If they come very heavily and they just know where to be at all times, there's a very, very, very good chance they are map hackers. More gold is required. Manage to just camp here. Towers are going to go up. In fact, let's get the panda out next. Get some items. That guy's come back magically. That windwalk would have run out, and he's going to get hurt in a moment anyway. Okay, so panda's up. May as well come over and creep this. Well, hang back a little bit. Panda won't be able to creep it too comfortably. Units, air would be pretty good. I could do something jokey like mass dragon hawks as well. That has potential. Okay, let's do this. But I want to beef up the heroes as well. I forgot that guy left. He obviously caved in very easily. But I understand why he left, but this is pretty bad for us, because basically he's useless. Completely and utterly useless now. And no one's going to put in the amount of effort that he probably requires to be played to get most efficiency out of him. Let's just tech up again. Start getting the Dragon Hawks. Going to want a barracks as well, actually. Oh, they're over here. Green's on the prowl. Got a TP in there with my heroes. He's got heals, but how much is he going to use it? Is he going to neglect? Unfortunately, I can't Stormbolt again, but we should be able to kill him, actually, just before he could even actually get another one in. I'm going for level 2 Bash here, just because it's more practical at this point. Okay. More Dragon Hawks, maybe? Because gold's really starting to float in. Might be going my base. I really feel like he might be. Oh, look. Who's that clicking on that? Is that that sentry ward you have? Looks like the enemy are now down here. Oh, Yellow's got enough defense, though, hasn't he? Jeez. At least he can hold his iron. Yes, my lord. What? Job done. Aye. Job's done. Perfect. Job done. Job done. Done. Oh. Take your time. Look around. Another round? Give me your pleasure. Aye. More work. There's too much clicking going on here. I want to see. Wait till you see me. Name your pleasure. My heroes can't get to him, so I can't do the damage I needed to do whilst he was slowed there. It's a bit annoying, isn't it? They do that thing where it's like, okay, I've got him. stun him, and then can't quite fucking move or do anything. You need to go all the way through. You can't just half-ass it. This green is here now, and he's got a decent army to go with it, so that's very nice to see. This might be too much, though. This guy's still kind of AFK. He's not really doing anything. Okay, good. We've got our armies combined. Wood is an issue, as ever. Tech's up. Should start to get... Oh, I can get Naga Sea Bitch, actually. There we go. Alright. Oh, I need a blacksmith now. Of course I do. Alrighty. So we've got our forces combined. Get the panda orb of fire, I think. And we're good. Let's move out. Start creeping. Start doing all of that kind of shizzle. Yep, good. Someone is teching him up. They are actually playing him quite well. Considering this is 4 versus 4 RT. That's respectably well. Every time I basically go over there to do something to him, I notice that someone else is already doing it, so... Not bad. Medicine Pig might be good. And we might want to just sort of go and attack. Or at least hit expansions and such, because my allies got bigger armies, but a lot of them are hunts, and hunts aren't that great later on. So I'm a bit sketchy on that. The Fort Lightning. Let's go for this. Gonna see if there's anything I can hit and run a bit. Researchers going through, peasants mining. Oh, hello. Got my eye on you. Ah, if only I could stun him again. Not wasting any more storm bolts. Oh, hello. What the hell? I was going to say, that can't really be your blade master, otherwise you're suicidal. What the hell? That's fine by me. More Dragonhawks, please. Don't mind if I do. Let's pick up some scrolls of healing and stuff. Just make it harder to kill me, really. Let's give the panda a little bit more longevity as well. He can have that. Mountain King is less likely to die, I think. These guys are horrible. Yellow is actually kicking this guy's ass. Although he's getting ganked from behind by the looks of it, so... Those guys are fighting though, so maybe not ganked from behind, so it looks like it's time to jump in here. Unfortunately, he's backing off here. Okay, I shouldn't have done that, lifting my hands just to do that. Okay, this is too many now. I'm not taking on three. I'll take on two, but I'm not taking on three. Lost nothing. It's kind of annoying because that pig takes precedence. I have to pay, press tab to do aerial shackles. Can see that this guy's got kind of out of control. It's taking up again. Oh, I've got too many units. Too many. Oh my goodness. I can't do my hockey cat. Oh, never mind. Whatever. Let's get the Naga Sea Bitch a bit more longevity, actually. She seems to want to die. Give Mount King a bit of invulnerability as well. That's nice to have. No, actually, I'll give it to the Naga Sea Bitch. There we go. Good to react now to something. Got a bit of a push out to do. The hell? I want to get more dusts of. Appearance. That guy's getting desperate. We're complete. Our forces are under attack. Take time. Yep, we're TPM. We're TPM. Get that paladin. Now the blade master. Oh, where do you think you're going? Pretty awesome. Pretty awesome. Who's nearby? Mountain King is catching up. He should be able to get a Stormbolt off in a moment. Unless he gets blocked by his own units. Come on! You're really working hard against me here. There we go. Got you now. Take all your pots you want. That'll do it. That'll do, pig. That'll do it. Yeah, I'd say that's pretty owned. Can't really argue with that. Don't know what this suicidal nut is doing. That's pretty fun, actually. That went through quite smoothly. Shame I've run out of mana now. I've got no mana left. Almost need like an archmage or an ally archmage to help out with that. The Wyverns were a bit overkill. Especially since I seem to have a counter to it. Take him down! And heal up. Level 5 Mountain King, so that's level 3 Storm Bolts. Level 2 Breath of Fire with a level 4 Panda. And level 2 Fort Lightning with a level... Oh, hello. Level 3 Naga Sea Bitch. Looks like one of the people are still there. Stop blocking your own units, for God's sake. If I send the panda past him, I can TP to him. Or maybe not, actually. I'm going to get it. That Mountain King is fast. That'll do it. That'll do. Well, I'm not sure who's still in the game. One of them is stubborn and doesn't want to leave. A guy called White Power. Dear. Warcraft 3 is always a good place to go for blatant racism. I'm going to turn off that frost arrow effect now. So that's top dealt with. Blue's pretty much dead. Pink next. And he's going to hole up in his base by the looks of it with mass towers. But those towers aren't going to do much versus Dragonhawks with the cloud ability, unless he has like an equal amount of Dragonhawks with his own cloud. Let's see what you're rolling with. Oh, he's TKing himself. It's alright though, I'll still take this. I'll kill what I've got to kill. Looks pretty cool actually. Good experience. Oh, he is actually there. Where'd the map? Ah. Oh, don't know. Ah, oh, there he is. I see ya. I wonder if he's gonna come back. I've got a Stormbolt waiting for him if he does. And he'll come back if he was going to come back. He'd come back about there. We'll get some frost arrows on in a moment. I'm just kind of waiting for him to make a reckless move with that Blade Master. Guess he's probably not going to do it now. Got no dust of appearance anymore though. Yeah, he's going to just defend up in his base. Which would make sense if you're being a dick like he is. Oh, Batsay. I've got a nice healing ward, so we'll see if we can make use of that. That's lovely. We'll be ready to grab any more bats in case they decide to come. Looks like I actually have no wood. Don't know what the hell. Oh no, it's because he was killing my wood peons and I didn't pay attention, so bad macro on my part. Alrighty. Back in the game. He's going to have a rough time versus these Dragon Hawk Riders. Oh look, what's he doing there? I really want Dust of Appearance so I can guarantee kill him. Let's send the Mountain King off. There we go, that's more than enough Dragon Hawks there. And that covers everything. Forces are under attack. Shouldn't really be anything able to hit, but just in case. That ability that Dragonhawks have, so underrated. Yes, I know, I did cast Aerial Shackles, but sometimes it just doesn't always work. This one should. Preemptive. Huh. He still had another one to go. Well, I don't think he has much left, to be honest. I'm not sure where his Blade Master is going to run off to now. Just keep cloud in the area. I'm not sure. I've probably got overkill amount of Dragonhawks clouding, but it's just to be safe. Don't want those towers getting out of hand. These are some pretty insanely powerful heroes. Damn it. Level 6 Mountain King now. Jeez. These Dragonhawks came in quite amazingly handy, didn't they, for this game? I didn't think they would be necessarily very good, but it turns out they actually have a really strong practical use in this particular game. Versus a guy that wants to mass towers and try to defend and hold up. Oh, the Blade Master's gone before I can even react. No time for that. Just too much around him. Absolutely nailed it. Look at that score. Really got carried away there. That's because of the heroes. They're so powerful, and the units. Look, 6, 5, and 5. 9 hero kills. I'd say that went pretty damn well. A little bit better than I was expecting it to. So Yeah, very interesting. A game where everything goes well and you actually can completely and utterly dominate with a bit of a powerful tri-hero, along with some very practical units like Dragonhawks in that game particular. Huh. Well, there it is. Okay, thanks for watching. If you'd like to help me out, you can always like the video, thumbs it up, and subscribe if you want to see more. I'll see you later.